There is the all truth, and there the timeless bliss. This is the offer made to Savitri. She is now in the transcendental realms. She has witnessed the aspect of the fourfold creator. She saw death himself now presenting as a tempter to her. He is telling Savitri, "Savitri, you have won a great victory. You have come into these transcendental realms. Live here. Here is all truth. Here is timeless bliss. You have won something which is most remarkable. You are now entitled to come and live in this world." But Savitri would not accept such an offer. She would say, "Give not the sun to darkness and death. My coming here and staying back in this transcendental world would mean you are giving your sun to darkness and to death. The real purpose will not be served. The work for which I had taken the birth will remain incomplete, will remain undone. The instrument which you have put in my hand cannot be broken unless the full music is played out. The strings cannot be snapped. I must play the full raga, the full composition on the instrument. And therefore I cannot come and stay here in this world." She knows that she can lift man to God. She can bring down the immortal into this creation. That is the work still she has to do. That is the music she has to still play on the veena, on the harp, on the lyre, on her instrument. And she cannot go and stay up there in heaven. But Savitri is told, "Look, what you are asking is something incompatible with the nature of things. Earth nature cannot hold God. The immortal cannot live upon earth. Therefore, what is that you are trying? You are trying something which cannot happen. Heaven's light, if at all visits the earth, it visits only once in a while. It goes there, stays for a while, and withdraws. The avatars come, great spirits go to the earth, they live there for a while and come back. In contrast to that, what you have here is all truth. What you have here is everlasting bliss. Bliss that knows no counts of time. Come and stay here." But Savitri says, "The silence which I hear is not sufficient to hear the truth. A few moments of the sages coming here are not going to solve the problem of this creation. Rare is still the call of heaven. Rare is still the response to that call. Savitri would be better if she withdraws. There is the all truth and there the timeless bliss. That is the sage advice to Savitri. But Savitri is not going to accept it because she says, my work is concerned with man. Unless that work is done, I cannot go away from the earth. There is the all truth and there the timeless bliss. But it is of another order, of another consequence, of another dimension. That is not going to help me. It has to come down and live upon earth.